In this video, we'll cover what not to do when you're traveling to Italy. From charming coastal towns to the historical ruins of Rome, you'll probably agree Italy is one of the places to visit at least once in your lifetime. But what are some of the absolute don'ts of Italy? Knowing this might help make your trip to this beautiful country more pleasant. This video is based on our countless trips to Italy. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel and enable notifications. And share your own experience or ask a question in the comments below. Let's explore! Don't assume all people speak English. Italy has ranked amongst the worst in Europe for speaking English. Although it has improved a lot in recent years, especially in bigger cities around major tourist attractions, we recommend learning some basic Italian phrases besides the famous ciao, grazie, sì and no. Buona giornata, buonasera, il conto per favore. Phrases like this will make your interaction with locals much better. Italians are generally very friendly and will try to communicate with you even if you don't speak the language, and will appreciate it if you try using just a couple of phrases. Just use some famous hand gestures and some Italian words and you'll be good to go. Don't eat in the restaurants located next to the main tourist attractions. Food in Italy is generally amazing, no matter where you go, but restaurants next to famous tourist places are not known as the best and are usually overpriced. There are many great places located just a short walk away. Use TripAdvisor or Yelp to find a great place near you. Don't expect an amazing breakfast. The typical hotel breakfast usually consists of just a coffee and a brioche. Italian breakfasts usually include something sweet, like a pastry. If you're big on breakfasts, always check with your hotel or Airbnb on what their breakfast includes. You can read the reviews online so you know what to expect. We had some of the most delicious breakfasts at our host's home and some hotels, but it is not the norm. And yes, your breakfast also depends on the level of luxury, the type of accommodation, and of course the location. Don't assume because tipping is not mandatory, you will not pay extra for your drink or meal. Tipping in Italy is not mandatory. However, most places will charge a so-called coperto or cover charge for sitting down in a bar or a restaurant, usually between 1 and 3 euros per person, and in some cases also the service charge on top, usually around 10% of the bill. Some places, like the Lazio region, where Rome is located, have banned the coperto. Always check before sitting down in a bar or a restaurant, so there is no surprise at the end. And just a quick pro tip, if you want to avoid the extra charge at the bar, order a drink by the counter standing up like the locals do. Don't forget to check for the lunch and dinner time. The typical Italian lunchtime, or pranzo, is between 12:30 and 2:30 p.m. and Italians eat dinner at restaurants around 8 p.m. In many parts of Italy, you can expect the restaurants to be closed between lunchtime and dinner. They usually reopen after 7 p.m., so plan accordingly. Or check Google, TripAdvisor or Yelp to see when the specific locations are open. Oh, and don't forget to take your time and enjoy the meal. And don't forget to eat your pizza with your hands. Yes, you can do that in Italy. If you're coming from the US, don't order spaghetti with meatballs because it doesn't exist in Italy. In fact, it was invented by an Italian immigrant in New York City. Also, don't expect ice in your drinks without a special request. Don't assume attractions are open daily. Restaurants, bars, and shops have different opening hours, sometimes quite confusing, and some of them are closed during lunch break. Certain restaurants, museums, and other attractions are typically closed on Mondays and some even on Tuesdays. So always check the opening hours of the attractions, restaurants, or shops that you plan to visit in advance. Just use Google, TripAdvisor, or Yelp. In August, many shops close completely because the locals go on their national August vacation, centered around the summer holiday Ferragosto. Don't just assume they are on time. Italy is not known as the most punctual nation, so don't worry too much if your service is not on time. It will all eventually come together. Don't order a cappuccino in the afternoon. Italians usually drink cappuccino before or after breakfast, but never after a meal. They avoid milk when eating, so typically they would not order a cappuccino after lunchtime. Instead, they enjoy a quick caffè or espresso, ristretto, macchiato, etc. Yes, know your coffee before you visit Italy, but don't worry, bars and restaurants got used to the fact that tourists order cappuccino throughout the day. And just a quick tip, if you can't find a public toilet, order a quick espresso by the counter that would cost you around 1 euro and you will be able to use the restroom. Don't forget to carry some cash. Although the situation is changing after COVID, paying with cash only is still very common in Italy. It is simply an old habit and cash is appreciated and sometimes required, so don't rely just on credit cards. Don't assume that all shops, restaurants, or taxis take credit cards. If you want to exchange your currency, there are plenty of exchange offices and ATMs or bancomats to get your euros. While most hotels, stores, and restaurants accept major credit cards like Visa or MasterCard, it is wise to always have some euros in your wallet. Don't just trust the GPS. Chances are you are going to use a car in Italy. While driving itself can pose a challenge, which is a topic for a different video, there are some things to know to avoid spending all your vacation budget on traffic fines. One-way streets, closed roads, rerouting, driving in circles, this is entirely normal when trying to navigate through narrow Italian streets, especially if you drive in bigger cities. We were once trying to get to Rome city center and ended up on the entrance ramp that looked like this. I know, right? But this is just common when visiting Italy, especially the south. GPS also took us to Zona Traffico Limitato when we visited Naples. A limited traffic zone is an area usually located in the Italian city centers where traffic is restricted. Pay attention to the signs, as they are sometimes relatively small and hard to spot, and don't just trust the GPS. The traffic fines in Italy are pretty high. By the way, smaller towns across Italy also have a lot of traffic radars. If you feel unsure of driving in Italy, use internal flights or convenient train transportation, such as fast Freccia trains, like the high-speed Freccia Rossa, to travel between main Italian cities, like between Rome and Venice. Once you're in the city, you can walk around the city or use public transportation. Don't forget to look both ways when crossing the street. Be very careful when crossing the street. Don't assume pedestrians have the right of way. To most Italian drivers, they don't. Don't expect to party hard. If you want to experience the European nightlife, you will probably have to go to Ibiza, Berlin, Prague, or another similar destination. Although there are some great party places in the country, Italy is generally not known as a major party destination. The country is more of a sipping Aperol while enjoying snacks and having long conversations with your friends type of vibe. On the other hand, Italy is full of amazing festivals and other celebrations, big or small, where you can have fun. Don't visit just the touristy places. Don't just travel to Rome, Florence, and Venice. And definitely don't try to see all of Italy in just 10 days, since the boot-shaped Italian mainland alone extends over 1100 kilometers or almost 700 miles. From beautiful islands, small historical towns, breathtaking castles and villas, to fantastic nature and stunning landscape, there are plenty of places to discover. Check out our video on the top 10 places to visit in Italy for some ideas, or our other videos on some Italian cities. The links are in the description. Don't forget to relax and enjoy. Italians love to enjoy life. The Italian lifestyle is centered around food, music, art, and each other's company. You can feel that spirit everywhere you go. So don't forget to take your time, soak in the atmosphere, and just relax. Dolce far niente, as Italians would say, which basically means the art of doing absolutely nothing and just enjoying. Don't travel with a heavy suitcase. Unless you're staying in a luxury hotel where your baggage is handled by someone else, don't bring heavy baggage. You will have to walk a lot and in some places like Venice probably even cross a few bridges before arriving at your hotel. If you travel by train, you will have to handle your bags and carry them with you at all times. You can also leave your baggage in dedicated lockers in certain areas, such as train stations and city centers, if you want to explore the city without your suitcase. Don't pack too much and plan to wear the most comfortable clothes and footwear, because you'll probably do a lot of walking. Don't assume the subway in bigger cities covers the entire area. Don't forget to watch your belongings. Italy is generally a safe destination, so you normally shouldn't be worried about specific areas to avoid or staying inside at night. However, typical for all major world destinations packed with tourists, there are quite a lot of pickpockets, especially in the crowded areas, close to major attractions, and on public transport. Don't dress inappropriately when visiting sacred places. Dress modestly when visiting Italian churches and other sacred places. Some places provide a blanket to cover yourself, but you should not count on that. Don't talk politics. Avoid making comments about Italian crime and corruption, the mafia, Second World War, Catholic Church, and other sensitive topics, as it can offend people. Even though many Italians complain about their country, as probably people in every country, they are still very proud of their great nation. And don't critique their food, which is hard to do anyway, since it's, well, one of the best in the world. Don't expect cheap luxury. Don't expect to buy an Italian luxury brand like Armani, Gucci, or others at low prices. Designers use standardized pricing, so you will pay almost the same price for your Gucci bag, no matter if you're in Milan or in Paris. Don't forget to bring a travel adapter. If you're coming from outside Europe or the UK, you will probably need a special European travel adapter to charge your phone and other devices. Italy uses Type F and Type C plugs, used in most of Europe, as well as the Type L plug, which is only used in Italy. We recommend purchasing a travel adapter before traveling to Italy, as you might have to buy one there and might pay more. In fact, it is worth purchasing the universal travel adapter, so you can use it in other countries too. Italy is one of the most amazing places on earth, and you will probably have an amazing time. And if you follow a couple of simple don'ts, you will feel like home in no time. We wish you an amazing trip to Italy.